How exactly do noobs go from aiming like this to getting cracked and pulling off elims like this? Well, today, we're gonna take a deep dive into the greatest aim training techniques that'll turn any player into an aim god. So to begin your training, we wanna ask, what actions or activities help you build the muscle memory needed to master aim? And what can you do to keep your performance at its best every match? The short answer is repetition. Say it again. Repetition. The more you practice hitting your opponents, the better you're going to get at it. Use maps such as aim duels, 1v1 stages, edit courses, and even fully dedicated aim training maps for practice. These maps all include activities such as crosshair placement, flicking to hit targets, tracking opponents, landing shots from afar, and so much more. And we're going to show you which maps will boost which skills throughout the video. Of course, if you want to improve your aiming speed and not just your accuracy, you're going to need to specifically build muscle memory using different sensitivity settings. Those default settings will only take you so far. Now, this isn't a settings and sensitivity video. However, if you want a tip to help you get started, find a pro using your control scheme and playstyle. Then copy their settings and see if it's a good fit for you. Make your own adjustments and work your way up from there. Any sensitivity can be mastered with enough practice. It just takes time and dedication. Here's a list of goals that you should aim for while following the tips in this video. Use them to keep track of your progress. Open up a peek and land a headshot. Keep your crosshair on a moving opponent. Be able to land a shot while jumping. Be able to flick your crosshairs quickly and land on an enemy. Be able to smoothly make edits while moving. Later, we'll teach you the best methods to help you maintain these skills. But first, want to learn how the pros effortlessly accomplish these goals every time? Check out our advanced aim training guide in the description below for even more pro-certified tactics to get you aiming like a gunslinger and fighting like a champion. If you want better crosshair placement while making edits, focus on keeping them between the lines on the editing grid instead of on the corners. This is what it would look like in slow motion so you can see it. See how no time is wasted getting from one square to the next? This improves your editing speed. Where you put the crosshair really depends on what edit you intend on making. If you want to make a side edit, you're going to want to keep your crosshairs in between these four squares. Then, using as small of a circle as possible, do a circular motion to hit every square quickly and then confirm the edit. Now, this rule applies to any edit combo, but also keep this in mind. If you're trying to hit an opponent behind a wall you're editing, make sure your crosshairs end up landing on your opponent when you finally hit confirm edit. Try this creative map. It has an entire section dedicated to training your crosshair placement. We're gonna leave it in the description for you. Flicking is an important skill you're gonna need to learn if you want to counter opponents coming at you from behind or the corner of your screen. Players who have mastered this skill are able to do a complete 180, land their crosshairs on their opponents, and instantly hit them for damage. If you're a wrist player, you're gonna wanna practice pivoting your wrist. Make quick, snappy movements and learn how far each flick will take you. Generally, there are three points to keep track of: left, center, and right. For flicking, your sensitivity will play a role in how far the flick will take you, so do this little wrist maneuver often to measure the distance. Arm aim is similar, but with one major difference. Because you move around the mouse pad with wider motion, you want your mouse placement optimized so you can flick without sending your mouse over the pad. Flicking will help you master your shotgun aim during close quarter fights. This map can help you practice flicking, but it also teaches you how to do so while on the move. Just pop targets as they appear and watch out for the barriers that also come through. We'll leave the map code in the description as well. If you want to be able to effortlessly track your opponent, you need to be able to spot them as they move, jump, and build their defenses. You also need to be able to predict what they're going to do next, so you can have your crosshairs on them as soon as an opening becomes available. You can master this skill through rigorous 1v1s. Having a human being playing a game with you instead of a bot can teach you how other players think without having to go through the effort of finding them in Battle Royale. You also don't need to worry about getting sent back to the lobby each time you get eliminated, which can really burn you out. Here's a 1v1 map you could start training on right now. We'll also leave some more map codes in the description. There are two different kinds of aim, and each one poses its own set of challenges. Close-range fights are fast-paced and often revolve around who's better at tracking their opponent or who can land the first headshot with a shotgun. Most fights will eventually become close-range fights if they last long enough or if you're deep into the late game. Some close-range tactics include spraying with your SMG or ADSing after a peek to hit your opponent for max damage shotgun headshots. For SMGs, you want to practice your hip fire. Learn to keep your crosshairs on your opponent while moving, and most of your shots will deal damage. As for shotguns, you need to practice both hipfire and ADS. Hipfire is great for dealing damage and dashing away, while that ADS is perfect for ending box fights. Long-range aim is all about precision, and with amazing ADS, ARs in the loot pool, this season you're going to want to maintain precise aim from afar. Later, we'll show you a map that you can put in your warm-up to strengthen this very skill. But before we do that, we're going to take a quick dive into your aim mentality. If you want to improve your aim, you need to maintain absolute focus on your targets. One thing that throws off players' aim is overconfidence. This is when you hit an enemy the first few times, and then suddenly you're missing your shots and your opponent gets the better of you. Now, why did this happen? Well, this is because your brain tricks you into a false sense of security. You did 110 damage and crack shields, then you start to lose focus because you tell yourself it's easy to get 90 damage. It doesn't take that many shots to finish off any opponent, right? Well, now you just got lazy. You've stopped caring about landing every shot, and now your opponent has the chance to make a comeback. So stay focused and treat every opponent as if they have 200 health at all times. Another bad mentality, one that really plagues controller players, is refusing to use certain weapons just because you heard rumors that the weapon is trash on controller. Yes, the MK7 and the Twin Mag Assault Rifle are easier to use on keyboard and mouse, but this shouldn't stop you from trying to improve with these weapons. Now, before we show you the ultimate routine to freshen up on aiming, don't forget to check out our aim guide in the description below for more advanced training methods. Aim training doesn't stop when you've built the muscle memory needed to land more hits. It's also recommended that you do some aim training warm-ups before every Fortnite session. If you're serious about improving or elevating your rank in competitive, a 30-minute warm-up across every mechanic will get you in shape. 15 of those minutes should be dedicated to aim. 5 minutes of horizontal and vertical AR and SMG training will help you hit moving opponents from afar. 10 minutes of aim duels will help you consistently land shots on moving opponents so that you're immediately ready to dominate the early game. So, do you think you can handle your new aim training regime? Now go show your opponents what you've learned.